Hi, I'm Jerry James Stone, and in today's video, I'm gonna show you how to make this delicious cornbread Benedict. It's super easy, and the best thing is it's super scalable. You can make it for like 6 people or 60 people, and it's just delicious and wonderful, and I think you're really gonna like it. So it starts out with this cornbread, which is pretty freaking good on its own, but it's even better with this Benedict. First thing you wanna do is you wanna mix the dry ingredients. That's cornmeal. Then you're gonna add in some flour, then sugar, some baking powder, and here's a little tip on baking powder. If you're unsure if your baking powder is good, test it with some warm water. If it bubbles, you're good to go. If it doesn't, toss it out. And then you wanna add in some salt, mix it all together, and now let's get the wet stuff. So for the wet ingredients, we're gonna start off with some eggs. We're gonna whisk those together. Then we're gonna mix in some half and half, and then we're gonna add in some oil. I'm using a garlic oil, but you can use any sort of neutral oil like a canola oil or even an olive oil. So now we're gonna mix the wet ingredients with the dry. And this is something you always do when you're making baked goods like this. It's important to add the wet to the dry ingredients. And now we're gonna focus on the jalapeno. Start with chopping the jalapeno. And a little thing about jalapenos or just peppers in general, if you like spicy, chop the whole dang thing. But if you're kind of cautious about spicy, the important part is to remove the white pith from the jalapeno. That's actually where the heat is. People think it's the seeds and they're wrong. It's not, it's that white part area. So you wanna make sure you get all of that out if you don't like too much heat. So after you mince up the jalapenos, just add those into the batter. And now we're gonna focus on the cheddar cheese. I'm just gonna grate up the cheddar cheese like you would and then add that in. And then just fold everything together. The thing with cornbread is you don't wanna overmix it. So just fold in the ingredients and then you're good to go. So pour it into a 9x9 pan and you wanna bake it at 400 degrees for about 20 to 25 minutes, just until a toothpick comes out nice and clean. Okay, so now we're gonna make our poached eggs. Well, they're kind of poached eggs because we're making them in a muffin tin. And the thing that's really great about this is that you can make a couple or you can make 25 or 100. It's really super easy. They come out perfect every single time. So our first thing we're gonna do is we're gonna create this water bath for the eggs. We're gonna start with a little bit of water, we're gonna add some salt, and then a little bit of vinegar. And this combination, what it does is the vinegar helps the egg coagulate, which keeps it together with inside the muffin tin, but then the salt negates that vinegar taste so you don't taste it. It's super easy and it comes with a perfect poached egg every single time. So then go ahead and grease the pan, just add a little bit of Crisco to each cup where you're gonna put an egg. You wanna add that water and vinegar mixture to each cup, about a tablespoon for each one. And then crack in an egg for each one that you're making and put it into the oven. Bake it at 350 degrees for about 10 minutes. So when those eggs are done, don't turn off that oven because now we're gonna make the spinach. Take the spinach, toss it with a little bit of olive oil, spread it out on a baking sheet, and then put it in the oven and let it cook for about 5 to 10 minutes. While you're doing that, then we're gonna make the hollandaise sauce. I love this sauce. I love hollandaise sauce in general, but this one's super great because it's super spicy. So we'll start off with a couple egg yolks. We're gonna add in a whole chipotle pepper, plus some of that adobo sauce, which is just super great. Throw in a little bit of salt, and then slice up a lemon and get some fresh lemon juice. So you can make this hollandaise sauce in a little Cuisinart like I am, or in your blender, whatever's easiest. The thing that's great about it is it's super simple. So start it blending, and then add in slowly your melted butter. And just let that emulsify slowly, because if you do it too fast, you're gonna have scrambled eggs. So once that hollandaise is finished, that probably means the spinach is done too. So now we're ready to make everything. Start off with like a couple big chunks of that cornbread, super delicious and spicy, full of cheddar. Top it off with that roasted spinach, pop on some poached eggs, and then just drizzle that hollandaise sauce over the top. So there you have a delicious cornbread Benedict. Like I said, this is an easy recipe. It's great for a few people or a lot of people, but it should definitely be your next brunch. If you like this recipe, give me a thumbs up. And if you have a cooking question, hey, just drop a comment. I'm here for you. And if this is the first time that you've watched it, subscribe. I'll see you guys next time.